Hello everyone, in this video I am going to discuss about an investment ideology that is being used by a lot of investors today. So the ideology is invest in what you know. So we will discuss more about this ideology as we proceed further. So invest in companies whose products you use frequently. So this is the ideology here, and this ideology was coined by famous investor Peter Lynch, that is invest in what you know. So let me give you a summary of Peter Lynch, who Peter Lynch was. So Peter Lynch was a fund manager at Fidelity Investments between 1977 and 1990. He managed a very famous fund called Magellan Fund, and this Magellan Fund, so he was the fund manager for Magellan Fund, and from 1970 to 1990 this fund averaged a 30% or 29.2% annual return, that is CAGR. Let's say 30% CAGR for 13 years for this fund, right? And he was able to beat S&P 500 stock market index very easily. So basically the returns of this fund was more than double the returns of the S&P 500 index. So S&P 500 index is one of the popular index in the world and in the US. And also during his 13 years at Fidelity Investment, the asset under management for that fund increased from $18 million to $14 million. That is such a huge increase. And also the craze, if you see, I mean, how much the craze was for this fund, Magellan Fund. So when he ran Magellan, he says that one out of every 100 Americans was invested in this fund, Magellan Fund. So that was the popularity of this fund and of popularity of fund manager Peter Lynch. And why I'm discussing about Peter Lynch here is that, so this is invest in what you know is his ideology, which he used in selecting many companies for his fund, that is Magellan Fund. And he got a lot of 10 bagger ideas from buying stocks whose products he and his wife and children were using frequently and also liked that product. So just using the products frequently is not enough for, I mean, buying the stock. He also used to do more research on it, but this was the starting point for finding companies in which he was interested to invest. And all these ideas are discussed in his famous book Once Upon a Wall Street, and he's also written another famous book, Learn to Earn. These two are very famous books of Peter Lynch. Now the question is, in the last slide I told you, right, about investing in what you know, or investing in what the product of company which you are using in day-to-day life. But that is it enough that, okay, if you are using product of some company, is it enough to invest in that stock? So for example, take the example of Lux. So many of us use Lux soap in day-to-day life, and let's say many of us are the fragrance of Lux, we like a lot of fragrance of Lux, let's say, and we think that, okay, many other people should also start using it. But is that enough for investing in the company that makes Lux soap? Is that enough? So the answer is no. So there are many other things that are important before you are going to buy stocks of a company. Like, you have to study, okay, you like the product, that's okay, that's the starting point. So you have found a company whose products you like. Now you also want to look into the financial reports of the company. So how much profit the company is making, how much debt the company has, or is the company overvalued or undervalued, and what is the outlook of the sector in which company operates. And also, let's say, it's 5 years, but how much percentage of sales does the product you like constitutes for the company? Let's say the example of Lux. So Lux is a part of HUL, Hindustan Unilever Limited. Now you have to also see Lux as a product, how much percentage of sales constitutes for the company. Let's say if the Lux is just forming 1% of the total revenue for HUL, then even if you like the product, it's just a 1% part of the company, right? Even if let's say the demand for Lux keeps on growing, it will be, let's say it grows from, let's say from 1%, the revenue grows to 2% or 3%. But rest 97% of the revenue still comes from some other products, right? So you have to look into those products also. What other products HUL is making, and do you like the other products also? And also at last, actually this is not the last, but actually first you should look at the management of the company. So in a separate video, I will discuss about what other qualities you should look into a company before buying the stock. So this is a starting point that, okay, you like the product of the company. Now you want to look into the financial reports of the company. That is the second point, and that is a very important point. And then I will discuss in my later videos that how to analyze the stock. And let's now see the sectors whose products we use in our day-to-day life. So there are some sectors whose products we keep on using in our day-to-day life. So this is the FMCG sector, that is fast moving consumer goods. So these are like the soaps, food items, and I mean normally the items, right, that used on day-to-day life. So you use, let's say, Surf Excel, right? You use Lux soap, Dove soap, shampoos, then food items. These are the FMCG sector. Then you use the banks. Then they are consumer durables company. So consumer durables means whose products you are going to use for a long time. I mean, basically, let's say take example of AC or fridge. So once you buy AC, fridge, TV, then you are not going to buy AC every day, right? Or every month or every year. Mostly you will buy AC, and after, let's say, 5 or 10 years, you are again going to buy a new AC, right? That's like consumer durables. Then you have retail stores. So you go for shopping to retail stores and buy stuffs from there. Then you wear cloths, so clothing companies. Then you use cars and bikes. So these are the cars and bike sectors. And there are other sectors also, like telecom, flights, movies, paints, that you use. And these all are the consumer facing companies whose products you directly buy from the company. So there are two types of company. One is, business to consumer companies. So the companies directly sells to consumer. One is B2B companies, right? One company sells to another company, that is different. So I'm not going to talk about those companies here. I want to talk about consumer companies here. And also, in this video, actually, I will be covering many of these products and the company which actually manufactures that product. And if you feel that I have left some of the companies, you can comment it here. Now, I will start from the FMCG sector, which is one of the popular sectors and whose products we use. So these are the products of FMCG sector we use very frequently in our day-to-day life. And these products are sold quickly and at very low cost, like Surf shampoos, right? These are sold very quickly, and these are very low cost items. And most companies that I discuss in this video are from the FMCG sector. So let's start with the first company. So you would have used like Fair Lovely, Ponds, Dove, Veem, Rexona, Lifebuoy, Lux, so Lakme, Sunsilk, Rin, Surf Excel. So these all are very popular brands for a company named HUL or Hindustan Unilever Limited. So that's the company that manufactures and sells all these brands. And I am sure that you would have used at least, I think, 50 to 60% of these brands in your day-to-day life, right? Now let's see what is the market share for these companies. So if you see overall market share, so that is if you see Pepsodent and Close Up, these companies form a part of the overall market care, and HUL enjoys 15% market share in this. Similarly for soaps, if you see, it has Lifebuoy, Lux, Pears, Dove, right? This, and it has market share of 40% in this. For laundry care, it has Rin, Surf Excel, Wheel, and they have a market share of 40%. Similar for shampoo, they have 50% market share. If you see, they have Sunsilk, Clinic Plus. And for cosmetics, of which Lakme is a big part, they have a market share of 20%. And for branded tea, they have Brooke Bond Tea, Brew, Lipton. For this, they have 20% market share. So you see, HUL, according to my guess, at least 90% of the people in India will be using one of the HUL products in their day-to-day life. And if you see their market share in all these categories, that's very high, right? 40 to 50% in many categories. And HUL is the biggest, or by market capitalization, it has the highest market capitalization among FMCG companies in India. And you can, of course, look at their products, and it's very easy to tell that, right? Because their products are being used very frequently in day-to-day life. Now let's go to second companies whose brands also we use in day-to-day life a lot. So Asirvad Atta, or Bingo Chips, or EP Noodles, or let's say biscuits so you would have heard of Mom's Magic, then Bingo Chips, or I already talked about Bingo Chips, then Dark Fantasy Chocolates, and popular notebooks like Classmate. So you would have heard of all of these, right? And the brand, so the company under which all these brands comes is ITC. Now, if you just think that ITC only makes these brands that is shown in the photo, you are very wrong actually, because ITC, the most of its revenue comes still from cigarettes. So it's a very diversified company. So it is diversified into FMC, hotels, cigarettes, and in cigarettes its market share is 85%, right? That's a huge, I mean, so of the organized cigarette industry, ITC has 85% market share, and some of its popular brands are Gold Flakes, Classic, Wills, Flake, and Navy Cut. And for packaged wheat market, that is, it has Aashirwad Atta, it has 30% market share. For cream biscuits, it has 25% market share. For chips market, through Bingo, it has 30% market share. And for notebooks market, through Classmate, it has 25% market share. So you can see how dominant the ITC is in many of these sectors. Now let's move on to next company. So this company makes products like HIT, Synthol soaps, Good Night. So these are some of the products that is being made by this company. And the company name is Godrej Consumer Products. So if you see their markets here, they are mostly into household insecticides. So if you see HIT All Out, right, these are all household insecticide products. And they have a 50% market share. That means out of two products in household insecticides, one product is always being sold by Godrej Consumer Products. In hair color segment, right, they have like Godrej Expert, hair color brands, and they have market share of 30%. And in soaps, through Synthol and some other brands, they have 10% market share. The next company here is which sold brands like Setweight, Saffola Oil, Saffola Oats, Parachute, and these are some of the famous brands of these companies. And the company here is Marico. And the markets in which this Marico operates is coconut oil. So in coconut oil, it has a market share of 60%, right? That's huge. And in premium edible oils, it has a market share of 73% through Saffola. In coconut oil, of course, everybody knows about Parachute, right? And in premium edible oils, they have Saffola brand. In oats, again, they have Saffola Oats, which constitute 25% of total oats market. So they have that market share. And in hair gems, gels and creams, through Setweight and other brands, they have 60% market share. Let's move on to next one. So this company has brands like Real Fruit Juice, Odonil, Dabur Amla Oil, Femme, Dabur Red Toothpaste, Dabur Chyawanprash, Dabur Honey, right? Of course, you would have guessed the name of the company, right? I have already told it. So it's Dabur, and I mean, their markets here in toothpaste is 10%. In honey, they have 50% markets here. In Ayurveda tonics, they have 60% market share through Chyawanprash and other products. In juices, through Real Juice, they have 45% market share. In digestives, that is, they have the famous Hajmola brand, they have 50% market share. And in Amla hair oil category, they have 60% market share. So you can see how dominant they are in each of these categories here. And the next one, and a company which I like very much, and they have products like Kit Kat, Munch, Maggie, and they have products for infants. Because infants milk powder, infant cereals, they have Nescafe. All these products comes under the company Nestle. So Nestle is not an Indian company, it's a US company, but they also have a subsidiary in India. And they have, insane market share in all this. So in noodles market, they have 60% market share. In infant cereals, they have 96% market share. So they are almost a monopoly in this. In instant pasta, if you see, the market share is 65%. In chocolates, it's 60%. So chocolate, Munch and Kit Kat. And instant coffee, Nescafe, of course, most of us use, it's 50% market share for Nestle. The next company is that manufactures, so you'd have heard of Gillette Saving Kits, then Vicks, Whisper, Pampers, then Pantene, Ariel, Tide, right? These all products are branded by another US company which has subsidiary in India, Procter and Gamble. And it also has huge market share in each of these categories. More than 50% market share in diaper, sanitary napkins and saving razor market through Zillet. They have 25% market share in shampoo. So they have, if you see their brands, Pantene, right? They have 25% market share. And 20% in laundry care through Ariel and Tide. The next one, so if you see on the photo, in the photo, all these are biscuits. So if you see the brands here, you have Time Pass, you have Good Day, you have Marigold, you have Little Hearts, you have NutriChoice, you have Jim Jam, you have, these are all the brands. And all these brands come under the company Britannia. So Britannia, you would have seen their ads, I think, on the TV, right? Many of their ads you would have seen. And they have a market share of 38% in biscuits. That's huge, right? 38% of total biscuits market. And they are some of the famous brands, right? I've already told, Tiger, Time Pass, Good Day, Jim Jam, Marigold, Little Hearts. The next one, so so now the next two companies are associated with alcohol sector. And these are also FMCG because they are also sold very fast, right? So these are also FMCG companies. And the first company I'm talking about has brands like VAT 69, Black and White, Black Dog, Black Label, McDowell No. 1, Royal Challenge, Signature. These are all the, so Big Piper, these are all the brands that comes under a single company. So the company is United Spirits. And the company has more than 50% market share in hard liquor market. So you see these are all hard drinks. These are not the soft drinks. Hard drinks means the amount of alcohols in these brands is very high. So that's why it's hard liquor market. And they have more than 50% market share in this. And the next company, again in the alcohol sector, Kingfisher brand, right? I think you would have heard of Kingfisher brand, right, in India. It is also associated with Royal Challengers, Bangalore, RCB. So Kingfisher is mostly into beer market. And the company under whose this all comes is United Breweries. And this company has more than 50% share of Indian beer market through Kingfisher. So if you see the difference, right, United Spirits had 50% market share in hard drinks, and United Breweries has more than 50% market share in beer market. Both are different. Now let's go to, so these were all the FMCG companies that I discussed. Let's now go to some of the other products which you use in day-to-day life, like banks, like so some of the popular banks in India. So these all companies that I'm discussing till now are listed in a stock market. So that's one important thing you should note, right? Because if they are not listed in stock market, even if you like their product, you cannot buy their stocks, right? So I'm discussing only the companies that are there in the stock market. So some of the popular banks in India, HDFC Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank, ICICI Bank, Axis Bank, State Bank of India. And these all banks also have insurance business, both health and life insurance. They also have sometimes AMC business, that is, mutual fund business. They also have this business. Actually, in India, all the banks which you see are listed because it's compulsory by the RBI to all the banks, if they operate, they have to list in the stock market. That's compulsory, actually. Now let's go to consumer durables. So consumer durables are those whose products you do not change very frequently, right? Like AC. For AC, you have in India, you have like, so there are many companies I have shown in this photo, but not all the companies are listed in India. Some of these are foreign brands not listed in India, or they are listed outside India. So some brands in India like Whirlpool, you have ACs, Voltas, you have Bajaj, you have, these are Indian companies. And yeah, Whirlpool fridge and washing machine. Whirlpool is a company listed in India, and it has dominant market share in fridge and washing machines. Similarly, when you in your house, you use wires, switches, fans, coolers, right? These are all mostly from Havells, Crompton, or Bajaj. These are all companies are listed, of course. In retail stores category or sector, you must have heard of DMart, right? Whose founder has become one of the richest person in India. And some of the retail stores that are very famous in India, and maybe you will be visiting these stores frequently, DMart is not a stock name. So DMart is a retail store, and Avenue Supermart is the stock that actually, so DMart comes under the stock Avenue Supermart. So it is a parent of DMart, Avenue Supermart. Then you have Future Retail Stock, which has Big Bazaar. Then you have Reliance Industries, whose subsidiaries are Reliance Fresh, Reliance Smart, Reliance Digital. These are retail stores which operate under Reliance Industries. Then you have Westside Retail Stores, which comes under Trent, and it is a part of Tata Group. Then you have a Central and Brand Factory, which comes under the company Future Lifestyle Fashions and is a part of the Future Group. So I think you would have, most of the times you would have visited one of these, right, in your day-to-day life, when you go for shopping or for buying clothes or for buying some digital accessories. Now, next one is clothing. So if you see the brands on the right-hand side, like Peter England, so from the name it looks like, okay, these are not the Indian companies, but these are the Indian companies. Peter England, Louis Philippe, Allen Solly, and there are many other companies here, right? So these all companies are comes under Aditya Birla Group, actually. So the company name is Aditya Birla Fashion and Retail Limited, and all these brands are a part of this company. And other companies in this clothing are Future Lifestyle Fashions, whose some of the popular brands are Lee Cooper, Indigo Nation, John Miller. And also another company which has just got listed a year back is TCNS Clothing, which is mostly into women clothing, and they have brands like W and Aurelia. The next we will come to the cars and bike segment. And in cars, if you see the brands here, right, on the right hand side, I think you would easily able to guess the company, right? The brands here, if you see Wagon-R, then you have Desire, Grand Vitara, Swift. These all are a part of a company, Maruti Suzuki, and which has more than 50% market share in passenger vehicles category. That means out of two cars that you see in the road, it is, and the probability of one car belonging to Maruti Suzuki, right, is very high, because it has more than 50% market share. And now let's look at these brands like Scorpio, XUV, then you have Bolero, right? So I'm not a very big fan of car brands, but I just wanted to tell you about this, like which this brand belongs to which companies actually. So these all brands are the part of Mahindra and Mahindra Group. So Mahindra and Mahindra is a stock actually listed on the stock markets. Other than cars, they are also into tractors, SUV. So SUV is also a car. They are also into tractors and commercial vehicles. So for tractors, their market share is 40%. For passenger cars, they do not have a very high market share. They only have 7% market share. For SUV category, they have 25% market share. And for commercial vehicles, like trucks and all, they have 25% market share. The next one, of course, written here, the Tata, Jaguar and Land Rover. So Jaguar and Land Rover actually are part of an Indian company known as Tata Motors. In 2008, actually, they bought this company, Jaguar and Land Rover, actually. And so it's a part of Tata Motors. And they have, so Tata Motors also has 45, or almost let's say 50% market share in Indian commercial vehicle market. So if you see any truck mostly on the roads, you will find it mostly it's manufactured by Tata. In passenger cars, they do not have very high market share. They have just 5% market share. As I told you, right, passenger cars, 50% market share is by Maruti Suzuki, and all other cars. So another car, Hyundai, has around 20% market share. So almost 70% is done by them, right? Rest 30 is divided between many different companies from India and outside India. Some of the popular brands of Tata Motors are Tiago, Tata Altroz, Tata Tiger, Tata Nexon, Tata Harrier, Tata Hexa. Now let's go to the bike section. In bikes, so Royal Enfield is one of the famous, bike brand. And Royal Enfield is not actually a stock, it's a bike brand, but that Royal Enfield is a part of a stock named Eicher Motors, which has given a huge returns actually. And you would have, in the news or on the Facebook or everywhere, you would have seen this, right, how much returns Royal Enfield has given. Like the comparison between if you would have brought the bike versus if you would have brought the stock, how much returns you would have got. They have 90% market share in Indian premium bike segment. So Royal Enfield is of course a premium bike whose cost mostly starts from 1 lakh, right? The minimum cost for buying a Royal Enfield bike is itself 1 lakh. And they have more than 90% market share. Like they are very dominant in this. It's a monopoly basically. And then you have Bajaj Auto, which has brands like Bajaj Dominar, Bajaj Avenger, Bajaj Pulsar. Then you have Hero MotoCorp. So these are all the stock names: Bajaj Auto, Hero MotoCorp, Eicher Motors. Hero MotoCorp has Splendor, Passion and Blazer brands. And also Hero MotoCorp is the largest two-wheeler manufacturer in the world. Not only in India, it's the largest two-wheeler manufacturer in the world. And it has almost 50% market share in Indian two-wheeler vehicles category. Then also you have TVS Motors, which has brands like Apache and Jupiter. These are in the bikes category. And also India is one of the biggest exporters of bike. So the company like Bajaj Auto, now almost 50% is from exports actually. Hero also, TVS also, they have a huge export to other emerging markets and also to other developed markets. Then tire brands are like a proxy to the automobile sector. Some of the famous brands are Apollo, Seat, JK Tires, MRF, TVS Tires. So if, let's say, if the automobile sector is doing good, of course tire stocks will also do good, right? Because they are basically a proxy to the automobile sector. And next we have paints. In paints we have Asian Paints. So Asian Paints has greater than 50% market share in paints. So basically, one out of every two, right, is using Asian Paints for painting their houses. But you have also other paint companies, Burger Paints and Nerolac. These are other famous paint companies listed in India. Let's go to another category. So this is not a category, but this is a category of like Fevicol, Fevistick, right? Fevikwik, right? These all are for like sticking purposes, right? Adhesives, they are in the category of adhesives. And Pidilite Industries, this is a stock name. And the brands under Pidilite, the famous brands under Pidilite are of course Fevicol. It has 70% market share in this. That's huge, right? 70% market share, another monopoly. And now telecom, it has changed a lot. So before there used to be like 10-12 companies in telecom sector, but now it's mostly a duopoly between Reliance Jio and Airtel. So Reliance Jio actually is not a listed stock, it's a part of Reliance Industries. So Reliance Jio is a subsidiary of Reliance Industries. And then you have Airtel, and whose company is Bharti Airtel, that is listed on the stocks. And both have almost now more than 30% market share. And with the issues that are with Idea and Vodafone, right, they are gaining more and more. And I see in future it's a duopoly. I think 40% 50% both will be having a market share. In flights also, if you travel very frequently, mostly there are many flights. So Indigo is one of them, SpiceJet is there. There are Vistara and all, but Vistara and all are not listed, or Air Asia, these are not listed in India. The only listed company is in India. So Jet was listed, but it's bankrupt, right? Jet Airways is now bankrupt, so there's no use of buying that stock. So Interglobe Aviation, like that has the brand Indigo actually, has more than 50% market share in India. And then you also have SpiceJet stock, and which operates basically the SpiceJet flights. And let's mention some other companies which are worth mention here, because like they also have very dominant market share, like PVR and Inox, right? For movies, mostly you go to one of these. These are also listed in the stock market. Titan. So Titan, initially it was popular for watches. Now it has Tanishq brand. So Tanishq constitutes almost 80-90% of the revenue for Titan. So Tanishq is a gold brand basically. In mostly all the marriages and all these functions, most of the gold are purchased from Titan now. Or not for Titan exactly, but Tanishq comes under Titan. Then you have Tata Salt, Starbucks in India, and Tata Tea that comes under Tata Consumer Products. Then you have Ujala brand that comes under, you've seen the ad of Ujala, right? So Ujala comes under the stock Jyoti Labs. Then you have Fast Relay, Boro Plus, Fair and Handsome. These are under Emami. Then you, of course, you would have used Colgate toothpaste and toothbrush. So Colgate itself is stock name also. Then VIP and Safari are popular for the luggage and travel bag, these stocks. Then most of the cookers or other stuff that you use in kitchen, right? They are mostly manufactured by TTK Prestige. So Prestige brands, right? Or the Hawkins cooker. These are the two popular stocks for this category. Then for tiles and other, stuffs, right? Associated with the home, right? In the bathroom, you have taps and other stuffs, right? For this, the other popular brands are Cera Sanitaryware and Kajalia Ceramics. So that's all for this video. And if you feel that I have missed some of the companies that whose products you use day-to-day life, you can write that in comments. And I hope you would have got a lot of information this. And in the later videos, we will also discuss about how to analyze these companies. So just knowing that, okay, you are using this product is not enough. You should also analyze the finance part of the company, analyze their reports, analyze their how good the company is for investment. Is the company overvalued or is it undervalued, right? So look at all these categories that we will look into the next video. Peter Lynch also, he didn't just brought these stocks which their children or wife like, just because, I mean, they were using it, right? Or they were drinking some brand of coffee. He didn't buy that coffee stock just because they liked that coffee. He also went in to see the financial report of the company, and after analyzing the finance of that company, then he took the decision whether to buy the stock or not. So that we will look into a separate video. Thank you.